Megan, thank you for coming by. Hi, thanks for coming to the ELN studio.
Great, thanks for having me.
We appreciate your time. So what is self-regulation and how important is it with preschool children, particularly in determining their ability to move into and succeed in kindergarten?
Self-regulation is a set of foundational skills that really are your self-control, how well you can pay attention and focus, remember instructions, do well working with others. And so it's sort of this ability to focus your attention and, you know, pay attention and do well, persist on tasks. Kids, you know, when they're three, don't have this very well. But when they get into kindergarten, it's increasingly important for them to have those sorts of skills because it helps them do better.
And is this something learned or does a child have it?
Sure. So some kids are born a lot more easy to soothe and they are not very reactive and they're sort of more calm, cautious children. And so they may have self-regulation more easily than other kids. They don't get upset easily by new things. And other kids may take a while to adjust to new things. They may be more reactive. They may be more just active. You know, some kids are just have more activity. And so they may need a little bit of help learning how to harness their activity in positive ways, in ways that will help them do better.
One of the areas of research for you has been the social and emotional learning, the SEL interventions.
Yeah.
What do they actually look like?
So a lot of those interventions help build these foundational skills for kids, like helping parents scaffold those skills for young kids. Can they help them listen and focus their attention? Can they help them work well with other kids? We have been working on a set of intervention games that are based in music and movement, but they're cognitively complex, and so they're fun for kids to do, like red light, green light kinds of games, but they're actually pretty challenging. They're cognitively complex, so they get harder over time. So kids have to stop and think about what they have to do, and then they might have to do the opposite. And we might ask the kids to dance when the music is going and stop when it stops. And then we might say, okay, now I want you to dance fast to fast music and slow to slow music. And then we might say, okay, now I want you to reverse. But we're just adding in new rules to really help them pay attention, focus, maybe do the opposite, which is actually quite important for self-control.
What's your point of entry with the teachers and into the schools?
We go directly, and in just a few hours, actually, we can work with teachers directly. Wow. We're training some teachers in New Zealand, and we did that remotely. We actually also have an online course that they can come and they can get trained on these games. So there's lots of different ways to try and get this information out there.
Is that the app that's available to parents and teachers, or is that something
that's
else?
That's different.
Tell me about the app. Is that right about
that?
One
of the real goals for me as a researcher and parent is how do we get science and science-based information that really is grounded in evidence out there in ways that people can use that is easy for them to do. So we have received funding to develop an app of these games and try them with parents. And so how do we make this really scalable in the sense that we can get this information out there and the kids like doing it, so they're more motivated. They ask their parents for these games, and there's music cues in there, so if you don't sing very well, you can play the music, but it's still a way for you to really engage with your
kids. And does it provide you back measurable data or anything that you can integrate into your own research?
Absolutely. That's part of some work that we've been doing for the last year and a half, couple years, where we are working with parents directly and teachers to give us some feedback about, is this working? Is that not working? Is this a way to continue to improve things?
Preparing for this conversation, I saw a piece, I think it was from 2016, that began, adding a daily 20 to 30 minute self-regulation intervention to a kindergarten readiness program significantly boosted children's self-regulation and early academic skills, Megan McClelland has found.
We know that these interventions can be effective. We know that we have really been specific and targeted in the skills that we're trying to improve. And I think that we're trying to make it really fun and engaging for kids so that they're really doing it well and they're continuing to improve on them over time. And we do find some really significant impacts in terms of their improved, not just self-regulation, but also improved math, especially math skills. that you wouldn't necessarily expect because our intervention hasn't really focused directly on math, but those same sorts of skills are quite important for you to do well in math.
Perhaps opens up a whole new vein of research
yes.
for you,
doesn't it? It is. Actually, it has been.
I imagine so. Megan, thank you. Thank you for your work. Thank you for coming by the studio.
Thanks. It's been great.